Sabi ko nga, meron akong advice sa mga millennials.
Oo, natulad ko.
Oo. Hindi, mga millennials na single dyan.
Oo, ano?
Ang pagtitipid ng pera, parang pagiging single yan.
Bakit?
Sana yan lang. Oh.
Hello!
Hello everyone and welcome to another episode. And for today, siguro ano tayo, pre-Valentine episode.
Wow! Kasi ngayon, ang lamig ng ano, no? Di ba? Malamig ang gabi. Parang Valentine's ng ibang tao.
Oo. Anyway, something related to relationships and...
relationships.
Oo. But particularly sa mga married couples, yung mga newlyweds.
Okay.
So, ano ba yung mga important financial goals ng isang married couple? Ano ba dapat yung... Kasi pag single ka, syempre, ang iniisip mo, mag-travel, mag-ipon ng para sa
condo,
bagong cellphone, or
kotse.
Makabili ng condo, kotse. Pero, I noticed na pag kinakasal ka, nag-iiba bigla yung iyong priorities. But of course, yung mga...
Parang ganun pa rin.
Sa'yo, ganun pa rin ba?
Hindi.
But when it comes to being married, of course, nagkakaroon ng iba ng bagong financial goals.
Oo.
And ano ba yung mga bagong financial goals na nabubuo pag kinakasal ka or when you enter a relationship? What are the things that you should what are the important things that you should start to consider?
Yung mga nabubuo bukod sa anak.
Of course.
Bukod sa anak.
Yeah, when you're trying to build a family, what are the financial considerations?
Or,
ano ba 'yon? Ano ba yung kailangan mong pag-ipunan bigla?
Number one is ano, pang syempre, if you plan to have a kid, yung pang tuition fee ng bata.
Okay, so if you're...
So ano na yan, nag-iisip ka na yan kung saan mo i-enroll, tapos saan kukuha ng pang tuition fee, ganyan.
So
tapos,
that's a new...
Yeah, tuition fee. So kumbaga... Isipin mo dyan, kailan ba ako magbabayad? Monthly, quarterly, semestral, or every year?
Oo.
Yun, to take into consideration. Saka anong school? Kasi even like for example, dito sa area namin, iba-iba yung price range eh.
Mm-mm.
Like for example, grade 1 could be as low as 40,000, tapos upper end mo mga nasa 150,000.
Oo. So, if we can expand na hindi lang yung educational needs ng anak mo, but the cost of actually raising a child, diba?
Yeah,
especially if you're newlyweds, kahit wala pa kayong anak, if you're planning to
kasama diyan yung ano, kasama diyan yung school bus.
Oo.
Oh, mga 2,000 a month, baon.
Hindi, but yun nga, even preparing for a baby, di ba?
Which is actually a lot of people miss.
Oo, na parang syempre
inisip lang nila para sige, asawa kami ganyan, kakaanak, so tuition fee na nakakalimutan nila yung medyo mas malapit na. But of course, bago ka magpa-aral, magkakaanak ka muna.
Magbubuntis ka muna.
Oo, magbubuntis ka
tapos
muna.
The cost of pregnancy and raising a baby.
Pero matagal na yun eh.
Oo. But,
but yeah, you have to ano, kasi not a lot of, I mean, when I talk to
yung mga
persons,
mga bakuna, di ba? Siyempre, may gastos din yan. So you have to
bakuna,
prepare.
3-in-1, mga ganyan. Tapos kung, of course, kung hanggat kaya mag-breastfeed, I would really advocate breastfeeding.
Mm-mm.
Kasi of course, you know, yung mga advantage na mas naging close yung mom sa baby, mas healthy yung baby. My wife is a pediatrician. Iba talaga yung lusog ng bata. Mas hindi tinatamaan ng sakit kapag breastfeeding.
Uh-oh.
And besides, mas ano siya, mas tipid siya.
Of course, yeah.
Pero kung hindi naman breastfeeding, talagang magba-bottle feeding ka talaga. For me, so kasama rin 'yun.
Yes.
Diaper kasama rin 'yan.
So, 'yun nga, no, pag bagong kasal, it's not just about getting prepared emotionally to a family life,
but
preparing financially when it comes to having a family.
Family package na 'yan.
Oo. And I think a lot of newlyweds talagang ang isa din sa mga priorities makalipat sa sariling bahay nila or sa sariling lugar.
Balik ako sa ano, sa pregnancy. Pregnancy right now, siguro magtabi ka na ng mga 200 or 300,000. Kasi you'll never know eh.
Right now.
Siguro kasi a normal delivery would cost you around 50,000-60,000.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes kasi
kailangan mag C-section.
Kailangan mag CE. So mas dodoble, titriple yung presyo. Sometimes like yung may friend ako, nagkaroon ng complication sa baby, umabot sila ng 350,000.
Well, I guess it's important to visit your OB so that you know the status of your pregnancy,
mm-hmm,
and you can financially prepare kung ano yung mga possible na gastos.
Kasi like some couples, no, kunwari magme-marry sila, iisipin nilang la yung honeymoon, yung mga travel. But you know, these certain realities hindi rin nila naisip. So yun, pregnancy, and then of course when you have your own baby, sabi mo nga going into their own family home na.
Oo.
Yeah, of which kailangan mo of course ng down payment kung bibili ka ng condo or ng bahay, which is usually 20%.
Well, I think it's important to consider na ano ba tayo, bibili ba tayo house and lot or bibili tayo ng condo
of which
or lilipat lang tayo sa apartment and magre-rent
or magre-rent. Ay, magandang topic 'yun, ha.
Mm-hmm.
Kung buying or renting.
Ako, renting ang sagot ko.
Bias ako. Another topic.
Anyway, it's something that the couple should talk about before getting married, actually.
Kung bahay
but,
o condo.
But right after getting married,
pero
it's
kasi,
one of the things that they should also plan. No?
Kasi, kunwari, balak nyo, medyo maraming anak. Eh, kung maliit lang na condo, you know, hindi, that would not cut it. Maybe a house and that would be more, would be more nakasya. But some couples right now, may na-encounter ako na case, ayaw nila magkaroon ng anak.
Oh, may mga ganun naman.
May mga ganun.
Kanya-kanya namang choice yan.
Yes.
And the same way na there are some couples na tipong okay lang sa kanila na nakatira sila with the in-laws or with the parent of one of the may mga kilala akong ganun. Kasi
tapang
kasi parang there's an extra unit daw, it's a compound. It's something that they should talk about kasi it's something that will affect you financially. Yung decision on where you will live.
Yes.
Decision on
saan ka magpapaaral.
Yeah.
Ganyan.
How are you going to support yung magiging anak ninyo?
Mm-hmm.
Diba? So these are the financial considerations when you are newly married.
Yes.
No? Ano pa yung mga iniisip?
Ako lang, no? They should already think of insurance.
Yes. Okay.
Additional. Kasi, kumbaga, pag may anak na kayo, you have financial responsibility na eh. So to the extent of yung expected siguro na tuition fee for the kid that you have, dapat at least meron kayong, or yung financial responsibility mo sa family mo, dapat may insurance ka na how many years na gusto mo silang supportahan. Kasi at least hindi na mahihirapan yung bata, you know.
Yeah, especially if you're newly married, syempre bata ka pa, mura pa ang life insurance.
Oo.
Kesa yung maghihintay ka pa ng several years,
mas mahal na
pala
yun.
Kukuha. So, since you actually have plans of having a baby, so eventually, you will have financial dependence. So, get the life insurance as early as possible.
Yes. And we can actually help you, you know, evaluate
how much insurance coverage they need.
And what is the best insurance for them. Yan. We can
and related to that, kung kumuha sila ng life insurance during the time na single sila, pag kinasal sila, it would be prudent to have your policies updated.
And evaluated. So, yung beneficiary mo, papalitan mo.
Idadagdag mo na yung asawa mo, syempre.
That's right.
So, it's something na they should take care of. Mm-hmm. Okay? So, ano pa mga kailangan isipin when it comes to their personal finance?
Yung mga goals nila, I think they should really sit down and i-map out yung mga goals
nila. Ano bang plano nating mag-asawa?
Oh, like for example, gusto nating pumunta ng halimbawa, gusto nating pumunta ng America in 5 years time.
Mga travel plans ng mga nila mag-asawa.
Or yung mga milestones, for example, gusto ko, kunwari travel plan, kunwari meron kayong at least 4 countries to travel to.
Mm-hmm.
O dilatag nyo na kung kailan mangyayari, and of course, you invest or you save according
you now kailan. Try to build a fund for yes, your goals.
For each of the goal. Kasi pag hindi ka naging investor, nag-build ng fund per goal, hindi matutuloy yung goal mo.
Yeah. And especially, I know a lot of couples na one of their long-term goal is actually put up a business, no?
Oh, isa rin yun. Oh.
So, if we are going to put up a business, pag-usapan nila, kailan ba? Anong right. klaseng business ba? So, that's part of the goal planning, no?
Tama, okay. tama.
So, ano pa?
So, basically, that's it for the finances.
Oh, so, if you're single and then you suddenly find yourself engaged and about to be married soon, yung financial priorities ng isang tao, nag-iiba nagbabago or nadadagdagan, yan. Nababago. Mm-hmm. And,
Ginusto mo yan eh. Ginusto mo yan eh.
The thing kasi is, yeah, ako mismo, na-observe ko na a lot of people don't sit down and take the time to evaluate their personal finance pag ikakasal na sila. They are often just focused on the wedding.
Ah, no. Dapat
in
they
fact,
should...
mas focus ka dapat doon sa marriage
because,
rather than the wedding.
Ano yun? Wedding is just one day. Marriage is a lifetime.
Tama. So, which means na aside from creating a budget para doon sa kasal ninyo,
yung mga mangyayari after
yes,
the kasal.
Yes, you should also sit down and talk about where are we going to live, what are our goals,
options natin,
where do we want to raise a child, are we
anong
financially
school,
yeah, are we financially ready to support a child,
what can we do, kunwari, ito yung assets ko, this is what we have, so ano yung sayo, and then how we can, you know, reposition these assets for our goals na combined goals.
Yes, and looking into having financial protection for the family, so not just life insurance, but I guess emergency fund. Dati ang emergency fund mo, it's for your personal emergency lang. Now, so it's the emergency na. Of the family. No?
At saka dapat pag-usapan din kung may utang pa sa credit card.
Yes. Oh, so, yung mga debts. So, assets, liabilities, income, and expenses.
Medyo,
so, kailangan pag-usapan.
Medyo nakakatakot, but you know, marriage kasi is kayo na yun eh. So, everything lay down and communicate.
So, and at the end of the day, kung kailangan nyo ng guide, we're here, of course. So you can just email us at admin@wealthartkey.com.
If you have any questions.
If you have any questions, if you want some guidance in preparing for marriage. No?
For marriage, for your married life as well.
So kung nag-hire kayo ng wedding planner
for a day,
for an event na nangyayari lang sa isang araw, it makes sense to also hire a financial planner that will prepare you for your married life. Okay. So, I hope you like our video for today. So, please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends. And of course, kung hindi pa kayo nagsasubscribe, please subscribe to our channel. Alright?
Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.